back. So today I have something completely different than what I usually do here on my channel. This is a very, very, very dramatic eye makeup look, as you can obviously tell. I wanted to do something different. This is not for everybody, but what's the point in doing the same makeup look over and over again? Yeah, I don't think I have anything else to say. If you want to see how I achieved this look, then just keep watching. So I'm starting off by grabbing some sellotape and I'm just applying that to the corner of my eye, making sure they're even on both sides. Then I'm using my NYX white eyeshadow base and applying that to the inner half of my eye, blending it up to the crease and slightly outwards. Then I'm using my Maybelline Color Tattoo in black and I'm going to apply this to the outer half of my eye and blending it inwards. Next, I'm taking this white shimmery pigment from L'Oreal and I'm going to pack that on with my finger and blend that out towards the black shade. Then I'm going to take this black and silver shimmery eyeshadow, wet my brush, and then I'm going to start to pack that onto the outer corner of my eye. Packing it on and patting it will cause less fallout. Then I'm going to take this silvery grey from the Naked palette and I'm going to start to fuse the two colours together, really just blending them together, and that will create that lovely gradient between the two eyeshadows. Next, I'm taking the color Naked from the Naked palette and it's a nice cool tone brown, and that is going to be our transition shade for the crease and just help to really blend out the edges of those eyeshadows. And it's a process, so just keep blending. Then I'm going to take Makeup Geek's Ice Queen, and this is a perfect shade to also start to kind of fix up and tidy up your eyeshadow. So I highlight my brow bone and I also bring it downwards towards the rest of the eyeshadow. And if I've lost any of the black or the white pigment, I just like to go back in and reapply it and then obviously blend it out again so it's not too harsh. Then for liner, this is so simple. When you have the sellotape, you just want to obviously apply it along your lash line and flick it out towards the corner of your eye as you always would. And here's my favorite part, is seeing how it looks when you take off the sellotape. Just pull it off really gently and you'll have a lovely cat eye effect. Then you just want to clean up all the fallout. And then for concealers, I'm taking two, a more yellow toned and a more white toned as always. I'm applying that under my eyes in a triangular shape as always, just to really lift the face. And then I'm applying it on my chin, my cupid's bow, down the bridge of my nose, and onto my forehead between my brows to really balance out the highlight. And then just blend and blend and blend until it is completely seamless. Then you want to set all of those liquids on your face. So I'm taking my MAC Mineralize Skin Finish and I am just patting that on everywhere I just applied concealer. And then I'm just applying any powder, translucent powder, to the rest of my face. Then for bronzer, I'm going to use my NARS Laguna, and as always, I'm applying that to my cheekbones, just down around my jawline, and I also like to apply it to my forehead, so I really like to buff that into the perimeters of my face. Then for blusher, I'm taking my Becca Flower Child blusher and applying that to the apples of my cheeks, and I always work it back along my cheekbones. Then I'm going to take my Charlotte Tilbury Filmstar Bronze and Glow. I'm going to take the highlight shade because it's so beautiful. And I'm going to apply that along my cheekbones, up kind of around my eyebrow, and then I'm going to sweep it down onto my cheeks. Then I took the contour shade just to really chisel out my cheekbones. Then I went back in with the Naked shade from the Naked palette and I really just worked that into my lower lash line, just to kind of smoke it out, but I didn't want to use a dark shade because it would just make it too heavy on your eyes. And then I just took this Collection Glam Crystals eyeliner. It's a silver gel eyeliner with glitters, and I just worked that along my lower lash line and I flicked it out along the edge of my eyeliner and my cat eye that I created earlier with the sellotape. It's so easy to do. Just follow along the line of your eyeshadow. Then I just applied a couple of coats of mascara, and then these eyelashes are just from Penny's. They're really long and wispy and dramatic. For lips, I decided to keep it nude, so I just went in with MAC's Whirl Lip Liner and just lined my lips, obviously. And then for lipstick, I decided to use MAC's Myth.
I really like a nude lip with a dramatic eye because it just keeps the focus on the eyes and it just makes sure it's not too much then because it could be a bit out there. And then I decided I wanted to use a nude gloss on top. This one was from Bourjois and I just thought that it would kind of make my lips look a bit bigger. And then I applied some mascara onto my lower lash line too, just to balance it out because it was so heavy on top with lashes. And that is basically the finished look, guys. It is actually so, so easy to do. I highly recommend using sellotape. It really makes everything easy. I hope you guys enjoyed and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye!